So in this video, I will be asking a series of questions about the anatomy of the brain and giving you a little bit of time to think of the answer. I'm going to be using three different models. Two of them are very similar, the sagittal cut brain, and then this one just has three pieces, and then there's Mr. Dissectable, which comes into a bunch of pieces. So I think this video is going to be a little tougher if you're very shaky with brain anatomy. I did another video, you might want to check that one out first, and then come to this one. What is this space? This dot? And this purple structure? The space is the fourth ventricle. The dot is the intermediate mass, and this is the choroid plexus. What is this region, this structure, and this region? This region is the hypothalamus, this is the fornix, and the pons. What is the white matter? What is this crack? And what is this? The white matter is the arbor vitae. This is the parieto-occipital sulcus. That is the corpus callosum. What is this entire region? And what is this little bump here? And then behind that little bump, this sort of pillar of tissue. So this entire region is the diencephalon. The little bump is the mammillary body, and the pillar of tissue is the cerebral peduncle. So I tell students, when you look at this, it looks like a seahorse from the side. The diencephalon is the head of the seahorse. The mammillary body, it's kind of like it would be under the chin. So I say that's the double chin of the seahorse. And then this pillar of white matter here, we just said that was the cerebral peduncle. The peduncles are going from the pons to elsewhere, so this is like a thick track of white matter. So this band of white matter over here, that is the middle cerebellar peduncle. So the cerebral peduncle goes towards the cerebrum, the middle cerebellar peduncle goes towards the cerebellum. What is this pink lump? What is this entire region? And what are the little ridges in that region? So this is the olive. It's one of the regions on the medulla oblongata. This is the cerebellum. The wrinkles are the folia. What do we call this crack? and this bit of tissue. The crack is the transverse fissure. This bit of tissue is the vermis. What is this entire region? The tube. The two bumps here. And this white lump. The entire region is the midbrain. The tube, cerebral aqueduct, the two lumps on the back of the midbrain are the corpora quadrigemina. So corpora, corp, is a body, like a corpse. Corpora quad, quad is four. Rigemina, think like Gemini, the astrological sign, it's twins. So this is the corpora quadrigemina because it is the body of four twins. There are two bumps on this side of the brain, and the twins are on the other half. And then this white lump we had pointed to before, it's just the mammillary body again. What is this? And what is this? This is the septum pellucidum. A septum is a wall. Pellucidum. If somebody is lucid, does that mean they are confused or they're clear-headed? It means they're clear-headed. Everybody always says confused, but if you're lucid, it means you're totally with it. So this is the septum pellucidum, because septum is a wall. It is a clear wall that separates your lateral ventricles. Down here, this, that's the optic nerve. Right, so your two optic nerves. The brain's kind of upside down here, but so this was our optic nerve, which is right below the olfactory nerve. This here is the optic tract, so that's like where the optic nerve is going to. So if we had both halves of the brain, you would see the optic tracts come together and they make an X. And the center of the X would be there. What do we call the center of that X? That is the optic chiasma. So that's where the nerves are crossing, and half of each nerve crosses to the opposite side of the body. So on this side of the model, they removed the septum pellucidum. What is the empty space we're seeing behind it? So that empty space within the cerebrum is the lateral ventricle. So we pop this off, and you can see that wishbone type shape is the lateral ventricle. So any of the empty space over here is the lateral ventricle, but there's other structures you can see as well. What is this? What is that? This is the hippocampus. This is the internal capsule. The internal capsule is just a continuation of the cerebral peduncle. So that tract of white matter that we saw here, that you're seeing here, that's kind of like behind the midbrain. I know it's a little dark. But that tract of white matter continues up and becomes the internal capsule. Once the internal capsule reaches a certain height, it starts to fan out. What do we call the internal capsule once it starts to fan outwards? So then it's the corona radiata. What is this? And what is that? So this is the caudate nucleus. This here, if you don't know what it is just a continuation of this. So this is the fornix. The fornix wraps around to the inside. The fornix is just a tract of white matter that's connecting the hippocampus to structures within the diencephalon. What do we call this outer layer here? That is the cerebral cortex, because, you know, this entire thing is the cerebrum. The cerebral cortex is the outer layer of the cerebrum. So if that's the cerebral cortex, the outer layer here, cerebellar cortex. What do we call this bit of tissue? And what do we call this crack? So this is the vermis. The vermis is connecting your cerebellar hemispheres. This is the longitudinal fissure, which is separating, if these are cerebellar hemispheres, each half of the cerebrum, cerebral hemisphere. Okay, so pay attention. Take this off, rotate it like this. What is that structure going to be? So that is the hippocampus. So before we saw it as number 190 on the other model, this is just the same thing, just less of it. So we pull out the brainstem. This entire region here. This entire region here. The pink line here. This is the hypothalamus, because this whole mound is the thalamus, the pink line, epithalamus. What are we seeing here? So that is the caudate nucleus. We saw it before on this guy as 188. 14, still the caudate nucleus. But let's look on the other side. This is something we have not seen yet. Notice the texture of it. It's the same as the texture of the cerebrum. That's because this is the insula. It's the hidden fifth lobe of the cerebrum that is sitting deep to the temporal lobe. What are these two bumps? And what is this space here? So these two bumps are your corpora quadrigemina, because they're still on the back of the midbrain. This empty space here, it's the fourth ventricle. We're just not seeing, you know, normally you have the cerebellum here, but the cerebral aqueduct is pointing right to it, so you know it's the fourth ventricle. What do we call just the top pair of twins? And what do we call the very end of the epithalamus? The top pair of twins is the superior colliculi. The end of the epithalamus is the pineal gland. Speaking of glands, what is this gland, and what is the little stalk that attaches this gland to the rest of the brain? This is the pituitary gland. This is the infundibulum, and they're connecting to the hypothalamus. When you learn about the endocrine system in AP2, this will come back. What is this? And what is this? So, what is this whole region here? It's the pons. So the tracts of tissue coming away from the pons, we already said. This is the cerebral peduncle. The little wing to the side is the middle cerebellar peduncle. All right, so that's all the things I can think of to ask you right now. I hope it was helpful. Have a great day, and have fun learning.